Good evening! This is The Late Show with Matt Slesky! Featuring the cast of Toddlers and Tierras! Musical guest, Matt Sakowitz! And here's Max!
Good evening, everyone. Thank you, and have a seat. You're all beautiful people. Welcome to Late Night. I'm Max Slesky, and I'll be your host tonight. It's class night, so in a couple days we'll be out of here. As a class, we've been through so much together. We've laughed, we've cried, and hopefully this video is going to do both for us. Before we get started, though, I wanted to thank a few people in the audience tonight. First off, the class of 2015, give yourselves a hand and everything. But sit down, guys. Please don't start a Twitter fight about this. Mr. Thompson is here. Good evening! You're the best principal you could have ever asked for. We hope you still blow out our eardrums every Sunday, even after we graduate. Who's gonna walk Bobo, though? Because I really wanted to, and I didn't really get a chance. That'd be nice. Mrs. Kovacs is here. Don't worry, Mrs. Kovacs. The video is just under 2 hours this year. Promise. Mr. Regini is here. We're excited that you're here just to join us for our nice class night and everything, but is your son here? Is he in the building? Can we call him? We could drive to wherever he is. We could work this out. Miss Burns is here. Thank you, Miss Burns, but make sure you update gradebook. We do need to graduate. We have a great show planned for tonight. We'll have some skits. We'll share some favorite memories of the last 4 years, and we'll have some fun interviews with celebrities. Enjoy the evening, and let's get started. Hello, welcome. So, because this is class night, I thought I would write some thank you notes to some people, and I'm gonna do those right now. Matt, if you would. Thank you to Michelle Obama for taking away our smoothies and giving us whatever the fish is. I really like the mini pizzas. Thank you, kids with giant headphones. Now we all know what gangster rap sounds like. And yeah, we get it. You have beats.
I actually like that.
Thank you, advisory, for being even a bigger waste of time than homeroom. We spent about a week or two deciding what the Eagle's name would be. And we got Johnny, which is super lame because we're like, it's not good. Thank you, Jonathan Law Bathroom, for being the weirdest place in existence. It's always nice to be told you're beautiful while you're peeing. Thank you, senior class, for all becoming DJs at the same time. Yeah, we know you're a DJ. No, we don't want your mixtape. Especially if it's on fire, like, who wants that? Thank you to all the couples who make out in front of my locker. Your boyfriend's going at geometry, not war. It's just angles. Thank you to The Rock for bringing us all together. Too soon. Thank you to the custodians for cleaning up all of our lunches. We might not have been able to finish them, but you did a great job. Thank you to Rags for answering all the Ask the Dean questions when there weren't any to begin with. You tried. A slow look there, you know. Finally, thank you, class of 2015, for all the subtweets, Twitter fights, and drama. You all act like you hate each other, but we all know you don't. So after that, we'll be right back with a couple messages. Thanks.
Come on, guys. Are we going to win this team? We're one nation of domination. We got to win. W-I-N. Win.
Are you okay?
Coach, eat a Snickers.
Thank you.
Better?
Better.
All right, guys, let's go. Let's run fast. Track on three. One, two, three. Track!
Yeah! Yeah!
You're not you when you're hungry.
Snickers satisfies.
Oh, hey, we're back. We've shared a lot of memories as a class together, and here are some of your favorites.
My favorite memory is going yard off Warren.
My favorite memory is Mystery Shanks class.
My favorite memory was when Mr. Young made me
and me
cry for 45 minutes after school.
My favorite high school memory is when all the people who painted for the law game almost fought the Brantford coaches.
My favorite memory was when Sophia Calvin got hit in the eye with the frisbee and me and Sarabia couldn't stop laughing.
My favorite memory was at prom when I went crowd surfing.
My favorite memory is this year's pep rally because everybody was so pumped and we all had a great time.
My favorite senior memory was getting coach's award for soccer this year.
My favorite memory occurred the very first day we all came into Jonathan Law as freshmen together. And I looked out among the 250 students and said to myself, what did I get myself into? But it's been great ever since.
My favorite memory is getting my gap closed sophomore year.
And my favorite memory is keeping it because I love my gap.
My favorite memory at Law is almost calling Mr. K dad.
My favorite memory is being in the drama club for the past 4 years with my closest friends and putting on shows like The Wiz and Hairspray.
My favorite memory was Ingalls.
My favorite memory at Law is when I chipped my tooth at track.
My favorite senior memory was in senior parking lot when my car backfired and John's driving instructor called me stupid.
My favorite memory is when we all fought over the senior rock.
All right, my favorite memory is making states for soccer senior year.
My favorite memory is making All-American 3 years in a row for cheerleading and going to London my sophomore year for All-American.
My favorite senior memory is every time we lost a soccer game at home, I would come back up to the locker room and press this.
Please try again.
And it would give me motivation to for the next game.
My favorite memory at Law is duct taping Miss Locke to the wall. It's a shame we let her back down, though.
My favorite memory is choir class.
My favorite memory of the class of 2015, well, there's many wonderful memories, but my favorite memory is the day, okay, we were taking pictures. We took one picture with all of our shirts being purple for Marin, and I got to the gym late, and all the kids were in the bleachers, and the juniors whom I taught, class of 2015, started clapping and had me come over and sit with them.
My favorite memory at Law is spending time at prom with my friends.
My favorite memory is traveling to London with some of my best friends sophomore year and cheering in the New Year's Day parade.
My favorite memory is going all-state with my sister in gymnastics.
My favorite memory of the class of 2015 is our trip to Kwazi last year.
My favorite memory at Law is when we had a fire drill in the pouring rain.
My favorite memory is that the first 3 months I knew Miss Rally, she called me April, and I didn't have the guts to tell her that my real name was Carol because I was afraid of her.
My favorite memory is when Brady Dennegan's sophomore year kicked me in the head with a soccer ball. Thanks, bro.
My favorite memory is when I forgot the national anthem lyrics.
My favorite memory is when Miss Mancini used to talk about how she was a hippie.
So my favorite memory of high school is actually senior year in econ. I went on the board and had to spell cash, but instead I spelled it with a CH and spelled chash. Never live it down.
My favorite memory was just being at the Law community and just living at Jonathan Law High School and just being a part of everything, okay?
My favorite memory is last year when Ms. Reshank said, "What's Gucci?"
My favorite memory at Law was sophomore year when I pulled the emergency shower in my biology class and we all had to evacuate the room.
All right, my favorite memory at Law would probably be Ms. Goldbeck's AP Lang class, or maybe physics. Either one. I can't decide.
My favorite memory is having this beautiful garden built at Law for Marin.
My favorite memory with the class of 2015 is all the dance parties we had when they were accepted to college.
My favorite memory is freshman year in Mr. Ragini's class when he made the Mike DeLorio song.
My favorite memory at Law is getting called out by Thomas Hickey Reshank.
My favorite memory is DJing at prom.
My favorite memory is when I moved here from New Hampshire junior year and some girl asked me if I needed an airplane and a passport to get here. She was serious.
My favorite memory is going 4-0 against foreign in soccer.
My favorite memory at Law would have to be AP Gov class, Mr. Zara.
My favorite memory of the class of 2015 is how tremendously well they responded after we lost Marin. And at the memorial service out on the football field, I felt so much pride and so much gratitude for the way the class came together and honored their classmate in such a magnificent way. I will keep that memory for as long as I live.
And we're back. It's no secret that Twitter has been basically the center of everything we do in high school for a long time. You know, it starts the drama with J-Law tweets or truths or whatever it is this time. You know, it's funny a lot of times. You got some really good tweets, and then occasionally people are just really mean. So here's some of the fun mean ones. We read them before, so don't worry about that.
At Hillary Lucetti, ouch, the door. I'm sorry.
Don't sit in back of at Izzy Janosevic in class. All he's gonna do is talk about D-Rose and block your view with his cantaloupe head. That is true. Cantaloupe head.
Congratulations, Davenport and Colombo, for being accepted into the one college where the only criteria is that you have to be able to breathe.
I don't know what's worse, the Great Depression or an Emily dumped at Temedsin 12.
You'd think after 7 years of being friend-zoned at gmarzul82 would give up. Hashtag she feels bad for you. P.S. I don't think your shirt's tight enough.
At J-Law Advocate, so can we, like, not have school tomorrow? I don't control the snow days! So ask Feezer.
Rest in peace,
sir.
I'm never gonna be a dean. Harsh.
I was the same.
Hey, look, at Dylan Vino, still looks like coconut head. Really.
Kelsey Kapasna's laugh sounds like a dying hyena being beaten with a stick.
At Eminem, oh, I mean at Chase Ardito, how much money do you think? How much money do you think Haynes has made from you buying all their wife beaters? Yo. That's crazy.
At Metal Rad, super lightweight, who looks like a raccoon with a big nose and always talks about the gym but never goes.
Okay, thank you guys. I'll remember this. I'm out.
At Jizz Lincoln's looks like she shops in the men's department. I do.
Yo, at CoolKid69, could have sworn I just saw you walking with a pre-algebra book. I took that class in 7th grade. Bam.
At the piece of Colin, King Kong or Sasquatch?
Was it because I'm hairy?
When did Jeff Ang get glasses?
At Herb Pritchard, I guess anyone can go All State who has a minimal talent and at least amount of goals on their team. Overrated. Alright. Still bringing home the hardware though. Still got the certificate though.
At GRags21, is it weird that law students are nice to you just to get to your son? Who wrote this, Corey?
At LawFran 2015, looks at caller ID on a Sunday night. Sees Milford Public Schools, ignores phone call.
It's gonna get hot today. Grab a ice cold sun drop and show us how you drop it.
Drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot.
And
cause I got it going on. Drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot.
A thirst quenching citrus soda just dropped coast to coast. Sun drop.
That's how you drop it.
Drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot.
Hey, you come here often? Unlike me, the senior class has a lot of secrets. Here are some of their confessions.
My senior confession is when I skipped school with my boyfriend and went to go find a kitten and got ice cream from McDonald's.
My senior confession is leaving to go to Mr. Max with Brittany at least 10 times this year.
That I skipped every yearbook class, but I finished with 100.
That I didn't study for any of Rishang's vocab quizzes in 11th grade.
Sophomore year, when I went to decon, I borrowed my friend's dress and accidentally dropped it in the toilet. And then I tried to dry it and I burned it with a hairdryer. I'm sorry, Sam.
My senior confession is to Mr. Young. Every single time you did those online quizzes, we all shared answers.
Our senior confession is the one time we went to Dunkin' Donuts and got ISS for it.
During a study hall.
I cut class freshman year.
When I didn't pass my license test for the first time, I told everyone it was because it was confusing, because it was in Bridgeport, but really it was because I went through a stop sign.
Freshman year, I pretended to like Mr. Negretti's French toast.
My senior confession is that I ran into a parked car with my car at a soccer game.
We told Mr. K that we were going to the bathroom, but we actually went to Dunkin' Donuts.
Sophomore year, the whole self-containment class skipped Ms. McCluskey's class to go to breakfast.
My senior confession is that for the end of junior year and most of senior year, I drove without my license.
Whenever I ask to go to the bathroom, I just go to the bathroom to sleep.
I painted Mr. Marino's driveway and threw beach balls in his front yard.
One time sophomore year, I skipped second period with some friends and we went exploring in the basement, but then we set off some alarms and the janitors came running down and it was really scary.
Group messages are life. Sorry, Mr. Young.
My senior confession is that I actually hate sports.
Me and my boyfriend made out in the book closet.
My senior confession is I take Amanda's parking spot every day.
One day when I was driving into school, I underestimated my turn and there was a tire there and I ended up hitting the tire.
So yeah.
My senior confession is that during cross country during sophomore year, when they sent us out on runs, I would just run to my friend's house and just sit there and hang out for like 20 minutes and then I would just run back to school because why would I run?
Hey guys, I really don't have anything to confess. Well, maybe the Ask the Dean questions. I may have made up one or two. Or all of them. Sorry, guys.
Freshman year, during the overnight ski trip, I broke the sliding door off the balcony, and instead of telling anyone, I just buried it on the balcony. Also, Mike, sorry about your moccasins.
My senior confession is every time I said I had study, I actually had global.
Even after being at this school for 4 years, I still get lost sometimes upstairs.
My senior confession is I'm a savage.
My senior confession is sophomore year, I spent the entire period in the wrong classroom.
I painted the rock white in the beginning of the year.
My senior confession is that sophomore year, I came to school wearing the same exact clothes I wore the day before.
My senior confession is this past summer, I went to a One Direction concert with Miss Golbeck and her daughter and actually had a lot of fun. I have no shame.
My senior confession is my favorite color isn't blue. Gotcha!
Confession is taking out the doorstop from the senior door when the underclassmen go like out of school because they're not supposed to, so sucks.
I just face planted on the floor.
Ew. Our next segment is one of the audience's favorites. Enjoy.
Hi everyone, welcome to Ew. My name is Sarah. And for those of you who are wondering, that's S-A-R-A, with no H, because H's are L. Joining me today is my biffle, Ashley Armstrong! L. Hey Ashley, what's up?
Oh, not much, just got back from the movies.
Ah, cool. What movie did you see?
50 Shades of Grey.
50 Shades of Grey?
Yeah, I saw it with my mom.
Oh!
Yeah, she like read all the books.
Oh! Okay, you wanna have a smile on?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay. Okay, time's up. I think we tied. Hand hug! Okay, Ashley, do you still take dance lessons?
Yeah, I take like hip-hop classes on Saturdays. It's like whatever.
Ew! You wanna show us some of your moves?
Ew! Of course.
Wow! I wanna learn that. Teach me that! Wow. Nice. Yes. Ew, it's my stepdad, Garrett.
Hey, gals, that's some pretty funky dance moves.
Ew, don't talk to Garrett. He's such a narc.
Oh. Just so you girls know, your mom and I are about to start a new game of Monopoly if you'd like to join us.
Ew.
No.
You sure? It's gonna be a lot of fun.
It's gonna be a lot of ew.
Suit yourself. One more chance.
Ew, Garrett, get lost. Ew, my God. Oh my God, he's so embarrassing. Okay, now time for the ew speed round. Ew, here we go. The Rock.
Ew.
Joseph A. Foreign.
Ew.
Chicken cordon bleu.
Ew.
Mr. Young.
Cute.
Really? Yeah, he's like a really good teacher. Have you ever taken his advanced psychology course?
Advanced psychology? What? Nope, never taken it. Okay, well, that's all the time we have on Ew today. So thanks, Ashley Armstrong, for joining us today. Ew, okay. Join me next week on Ew.
Hello, welcome back. Here are two new shows we'll be premiering this week on Channel 11.
They'll get cash for every minute they last. The one that makes it to the end will choose. Either go on a second date or take the money. Careful what you do, because you may be next.
Hi, I'm Mikey. I'm 19 and I'm a personal trainer, and I hope I don't have to whip these girls into shape. My friends call me Magic Mike.
Yeah!
I'm ready for love. Bring out the ladies.
Oh my God.
Hey, what's up?
Just wanted to make sure you're okay. Next.
What? You're missing out on all this. I can't believe I just busted my ass and he nexted me. I'm done. I am Z-O-N-E, done. Come on, Spanky.
Hi.
Hi, say hi to my dog.
So, how are you?
I'm good. Ask how my dog is.
Oh, next.
Come on, Spanky. Come on, Spanky. Hi, I'm Ashley, and I'm single, and I'm ready to mingle.
Finally, someone normal.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. How are you? Good looking. Next!
My mama wouldn't approve of you anyway!
Hi, I'm Melissa, and I'm just really excited to meet the man of my dreams.
Ah, you're the girl from Vine!
Yeah, I am.
Oh, you like, going to the gym?
Okay, never mind.
And we're back. No one knows what the future holds for us. Here's what the senior class of 2015 hopes for.
In 10 years, I see myself finishing college and becoming an APRN.
10 years from now, I want to get a degree in psychology.
and I want to graduate from Southern.
10 years from now, I'm going to be pulling brake pads off the shelves at AutoZone.
In 10 years, I'm going to be a real estate agent selling apartments on Park Avenue.
In 10 years, I will be living in El Paso in a mansion with 20 kids and 6 dogs.
In 10 years from now, I'm still going to be trying to beat this level.
In 10 years, hopefully I'll be done with medical school and I'll be a doctor.
And I'll be Ming's physician assistant.
I think we should have 10 years, get married, have a job, have a children.
10 years, I want to be wealthy and successful.
In 10 years, I'll be a successful lawyer.
In 10 years, I'm going to be living in a small apartment with my 10 Polish children and my Polish wife.
In 10 years, I see myself hopefully being an English major.
In 10 years, I'm going to be homeless and living in a cardboard box.
In 10 years, I'll probably still be in medical school.
All right, in 10 years, I'm going to be playing in the World Cup.
In 10 years, I'm going to be in jail because I got arrested for being too cool.
In 10 years, I'll still probably be working on cars.
In 10 years from now, I'll be working for the New York Knicks.
In 10 years from now, I will be the first woman in the NFL.
10 years from now, I'm going to be a cosmonaut.
I don't know.
In 10 years, I hope to become a doctor and move to Florida.
I just want to wear a blazer. In 10 years.
In 10 years, I will either be a successful singer or a hobo.
In 10 years, hopefully I will be working at ACI Dynamics.
In 10 years, I'm going to be a woman.
In 10 years, I'm either still going to be in the Air Force or I'm going to be a cop.
In 10 years from now.
Melissa and I will be running against Gabe Tan for vice president.
Yep. In 10 years, I'll still be dyeing my hair a new color every single week.
10 years from now, I'm still going to be hanging out with this nub.
10 years from now, I'm going to be a billionaire.
10 years from now, we're going to be firefighters.
Hopefully, I'll be an event planner, living somewhere warm, making a lot of money.
In 10 years, I'll be 27 with a couple kids, hopefully not divorced.
10 years from now, I hope to own my own business and be flipping houses with my buddies.
10 years from now, I'm going to be married to my sugar mama, and she will support me in every single way.
In 10 years, I will still be in this chair.
In 10 years, I see myself... You're literally so rude. In 10 years, I see myself being the star of everything. I'm going to be on Broadway. I'm going to be in movies. I'm going to be away from Batson. And it's going to be a good life. Bye.
I want to hopefully be an investigative journalist, exposing political corruption and exposing injustice.
10 years from now, I'm going to be the new Ellen DeGeneres.
10 years from now, I will hopefully have my robotics PhD.
In 10 years, we will be living in a cardboard box together. Right, Brandon?
Yeah.
In 10 years, I will be living the dream in my parents' basement.
In 10 years, I will be sitting in a pile of debt from college.
I'll still be working on the album.
In 10 years, people will stop mixing me up with Jeff Ang.
In 10 years, I'll be a PRN, a nurse.
In 10 years, I'll be a successful businesswoman walking down Wall Street.
In 10 years, I will be visiting my favorite teachers at law.
All right, so in 10 years, you're going to be where?
Nowhere.
Awesome. Can I get a high five? No. Yeah.
Welcome back. Our next guests are from the show Toddlers and Tiaras. If you missed their latest episode, here it is.
My baby girl's going to win.
We've been doing pageants for about 4 years now. I'm pretty confident that we're gonna win. I mean, come on, look at my daughter. She's drop dead gorgeous.
We are gonna make you look so pretty for this pageant. Yes,
oh, my dad, I hate you.
Oh, baby, come back.
I hate pageants and I hate my dad.
These are all the trophies that Sophie has won. She was born to be a star. We actually named her Sophie because it rhymes with...
Nothing.
It rhymes with trophy! Yeah!
I definitely think I was born to be a pageant dad. That's the only reason I wanted a daughter. We did our first pageant, she was just 3 weeks old. He or she won the ultimate grand supreme. Don't you remember?
No, not really.
I'm feeling myself.
I didn't realize there were so many pageant ads out there.
Welcome to the Little Miss Nice Pretty Sexy Angel Jonathan Law Milford Connecticut pageant. We have a lot of new and old contestants here today. I want to wish everyone luck today, and without further ado, let's get started.
And this is Trinity. Her favorite activities are singing, whittling, and going to church. When she grows up, she wants to be a pastor. Give it up for Trinity! And this is Sophie. Her favorite activities include wearing black, shopping at Hot Topic, and lighting things on fire. When she grows up, she wants to be a mortician.
Yes, baby! Yes, yes, yes! Oh, you forgot your flipper!
Give it up for Sophie! And last but not least is Katrina. Her favorite activities include hula hooping, dirt biking with daddy, and running around in circles. When she grows up, she wants to be a horse groomer.
You know, Sophie would never do that. That can cost them ultimate, super, grand, supreme. What a shame. What a shame.
And the winner of the Little Miss Nice Pretty Sexy Angel Jonathan Locke Milford Connecticut pageant is... Trinity!
I didn't expect this at all. This was our first pageant, and all I have to say is, y'all need Jesus.
Well, that was a thing, I think. Actually, we have two special guests, the pageant parents. Come on in, guys. So, you were both a big part of whatever that was. How does it feel to be victorious in the pageants?
Oh, it was awesome. She did a really great job in her performance, and I couldn't be prouder of her.
And your daughter did really good. How does that feel just to be proud of something like that?
Oh, well, I know my daughter did good, but I just gotta say is that, her daughter sucks. Like, I don't get how she won.
Excuse you.
Excuse yourself.
She did amazing.
Step. You're talking about my daughter?
We're gonna throw it to commercials, so just, we'll be right back.
I'm working for an hourly wage. I went to high school, didn't do great. Still, I gotta make more cash. More education is what I'm looking at. When I get a degree, I will make a bigger salary. So now I've got to see which college is right for me. I went on the internet and found Education Connection. I took some free tests to find out my direction. I'm taking my classes online, getting my degree. Education Connection matched me with the right college for free. Get connected for free, free with Education Connection. Get connected for free, free with Education Connection.
Why the rose that grew from the concrete had damaged petals. On the contrary, we would all celebrate its tenacity. We would all love its will to reach the sun. Well, we are the roses. This is the concrete. These are my damaged petals. Don't ask me why. Ask me how.
In recent years, the selfie has been invented. Now here's a slideshow of a lot of them.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble in my drag.
Child, fly! Here are some teacher farewells.
Hey, class of 2015. It has been a long and winding road. I am very proud of all your accomplishments and everywhere you all are going next year. Shout out to my senior class officers. You guys are the best. I could have not done half the work without you. I appreciate all your hard work. Always remember, run like the herd. Nothing like spending a Friday night watching a cow poop. Have a great life and make sure you come back and visit.
Goodbye, class of 2015. You guys are the strongest kids I've ever known. Hope you all do well in the future.
Hello, seniors. This is your farewell. It's time for me to say goodbye, but I don't want to. So I'm not going to. So you're going to stop by and see me whenever you want to, because I'm not going to say goodbye yet. Farewell.
So Carol Phillips says I will be crying big tears for the senior class, although they will be crocodile tears, if any tears at all. No, seriously, seniors, I will miss you. It has been a pleasure getting to work with you over the last 2 years, as I don't get you till you're juniors. And I wish you all the best in your future endeavors.
I would like to say goodbye to the class of 2015, generally speaking, but in particular, I'd like to give my goodbyes to the fabled four of my Latin class this year. That's Sean Rice, Max Gurman, Mick Murray, and my good friend, Dylan. Thank you for making that class so much fun, and I trust that God will bless you in the future and that you can use your Latin to your own profit and the benefit of others in years ahead.
Hey, seniors, I just want to say goodbye to you, and I want to wish you good luck in the future in college, and I hope that you guys love life, change the world, and become the best versions of yourself.
To the class 2015, well, like I said, you came in saying words like YOLO, shun people. You're probably the most extracurricular activity class I've ever seen. But as you guys grew, I was so impressed and more importantly honored to be a part of your lives for the last 4 years. I wish you all the best of luck and good luck.
I want to wish you so much luck and happiness in the future. I will miss you all. You've meant so much to me, and I will obviously never forget you. I will think of you at the day for Peace, Love, and Music for Marin, because it was probably the best day I've had in my career to see you guys so happy, and I love you all, and I'll miss you.
Class of 2015, it's that time. It's been real, it's been nice, but it hasn't been real nice. Yes, it has. Guys, I wish you all the best of luck when you're on your future endeavors, so you don't forget this face, profile, regular, profile, because I know when you go away, you're going to miss this face. Good luck. We miss you. You've been a great class. Now get out. Hit the road. Hit the road, just my man Ray Charles says. Hit the road, class. Don't you come back no more. Only kidding. We want you to come back. We'll miss you. Good luck. Peace.
Hi, class of 2015. My goodbye message to you is going to be words that I'm taking from Bob Dylan, and I'm going to say, may God bless you and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others, and may others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung, and may you stay forever young. And a special message to those of you with the last names G-E through L-E. It's been my pleasure and honor to be your counselor for the last 2 years. So good luck, and make me proud.
Farewell is always bittersweet, especially for a great group of seniors like you guys. You're going to be missed. I miss all of you, especially my key clubbers and all the kids here who have made Jonathan Law the great place that it is. I wish you the best of luck, continued success, and don't be strangers. Make sure you come back and visit. Bye-bye.
Brush daily. Look both ways before you cross the street. Don't ride with people who are drinking or doing drugs. Don't drive if you're drinking and doing drugs. Don't talk smack on the street. Be good. Love you.
Farewell to the class of 2015, the first senior class for me here at Law, and I'd like to especially say goodbye to my awesome 9 kids in my advisory. Good luck in the future.
Congratulations on your graduation. I had you guys as my first freshman class 4 years ago, and I was not thrilled. You guys were kind of tough, and I kind of hated you, but now I've come to love all of you, and I'm lucky enough to have some of you again this year. I know you guys are going to go on to do great things. Have fun. Be good, but don't forget to come back and visit. Congratulations.
People come and people go. It happens every day. Though goodbye is just a simple word, I find it hard to say. And as I watch you leave me now, I try hard not to cry. For this is not the only time I'll have to say goodbye. You are not the only friends I'll pass along the way. And goodbye is just a simple word I'll have to learn to say. Good luck, class of 2015. We love you and we'll miss you.
Class 2015, I will miss you greatly. You were a great bunch. In the beginning, certainly your freshman year, I was worried about a plethora of you. But most of you proved me wrong. Some of you, who may be a little bit more annoying than others, I won't say her name, but we'll just leave it at that. Still a great person, great student. I miss you greatly. I do hope you stop by and see me. To those of you I've taught, like I said, I'll never stop being your teacher. So if you need me for anything, stop by. Take care.
Farewell, class of 2015.
Hi, this is Miss Mannion. Just want to wish the class of 2015 all the best. You've had a great 4 years here, and we wish you all the best as you move forward to college, to a career, into the military, whatever you do. We will never forget you. Obviously, you are a very, very special class with the loss of your beloved classmate, Marin, and we will keep you in our hearts forever. And we love you, and we want you to be safe. Always wear your seatbelt and come back and visit whenever you can. God bless. Love you guys.
Don't forget, when I'm not here next year, and you aren't either, about the stuffing. Don't forget the most important part of Thanksgiving. Also, I'd like to say au revoir, which means see you later, alligator, or Elvider, something. And then also in Polish, do widzenia.
Seniors, I want to wish you the absolute best. We're going to miss you guys so much. Hope you have a great experience in college or wherever you're moving. Wish you the best of luck. Congratulations.
Goodbye, seniors. I want to wish you the best of luck. I've been thinking a lot about this and remembering the first time I met many of you. I went in to observe Mrs. Reshank in an English class. It was the first observation I had done here at Jonathan Law. I walked in and about 30 of you were sitting there, kind of snickering and looking at me a little bit strange. And all of a sudden, in came this whirlwind known as Miss Reshank, screaming, "Namaste, namaste." And I'm looking around, who's namaste? Before you know it, everyone was doing the tree pose. That was the moment I learned you seniors, at that time sophomores, were awesome sports because she loved you to pieces and I got to learn how to do yoga. So thanks for the memories. Thanks for teaching me yoga. Good luck.
Hi, seniors. Happy class night. Congratulations to all the class of 2015. I'm on the late night show with Max Lusky right now. This is a big moment for me. I'd like to thank a couple of seniors in particular. I'd like to give a congratulations to all of my Advocate seniors, my Eagle Eye News seniors, tennis seniors, and my Powder Puff seniors. You guys will be sorely missed. So many great memories that we'll take with us. I'm going to be a little sentimental. Usually as teachers, we're used to teaching you guys about a subject or about life. I feel like this senior class is a little bit different. I feel like you guys, the class of 2015, taught us, the faculty here, a lot about life and a lot about who you guys are. With everything you've been through in the last 2 years and your whole high school career, I know I'm going to take that memory with me of you guys, just how strong you've been and how mature you've been and how funny you are and how you just dealt with things that normal classes don't have to deal with, and did an amazing job and showed our school and our community so much strength. So that's what I'm going to remember about you guys. Don't be strangers. I'm not going to say goodbye because friends don't say goodbye. They say see you later. So we'll see you guys around. We'll see you later. And when you come back, remember, most importantly, bring coffee with you. Duncan's right there. We know because you leave every day and go. So we know you know where it is. Bring us all coffee when you come back. We're going to miss you. Best of luck in the future, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
Class of 2015, what I will miss most about you, well, is everything. We came in together. We've had some really good times and some really tough times, and yet together we've all gone through it. Bobo is now licking the camera person's feet. I know he will miss that, but please remember, no matter where life takes you, you always have a place here, and if you ever need anything, you know where to find me. Best of luck to everyone.
Bittersweet memories, seniors. That is all I'm taking with me. So goodbye. Please don't cry. We both know I'm all that you need.
Hey guys, class of 2015, did you ever think this day would come? Seems like just yesterday you guys were freshmen. And now in a few days you'll be graduating. It's kind of crazy. You know, I know Beeler probably already told you guys, it's time to go. Don't let the door hit you where the good Lord split you. Get out of here, bye. And Batson probably did something stupid and embarrassing, make us all sweat while we're watching the video. And Cavanna, a man of very few words, probably said, "Hey, good luck. Have fun in college." But to be honest, I've been struggling this year thinking about what I'm gonna say to you guys. You know, we all know it hasn't been an easy 4 years, and especially last year with the loss of Marin. And each graduating class is special in their own way. But you guys, this class has taught me so much, more than you would ever know. You know, you learn a lot about someone's character when they are faced with adversity. And it's easy when everything is fine and going your way. But how will you act when things are not going your way? And to see the way you guys stuck together, helped each other, helped us adults, your resiliency, it was and still is just amazing. And now that you guys are young adults and moving on in whatever path you choose, I am confident, more confident than I've ever been of any senior class, that I know you will succeed in whatever path you take on. And I just want to leave you guys with three pieces of advice. First thing, number one, do not sweat the small stuff. Don't let the little things in life drive you crazy. Number two, everything you do, do it the best you possibly can. Put 100% in 100% of the time. And number three, this may be hard for some of you, do the right thing even when no one is looking. And that's all I got, guys. It was my pleasure being your dean, talking to you guys at lunch, and just saying hi to you guys in the hallway. I really love you guys, and I wish you nothing but the best in all you do to the class of 2015. Take care.
That's our show for today. If you want to rewatch today's episode, you'll probably find it on YouTube or something like that. Have a great night and have a great graduation.